شاء الله.
سورة الليل. والليل إذا يغشى والنهار إذا تجلى وما خلق الذكر والأنثى إن سعيكم لشتى. By the night as it envelopes, by the day as it appears in brightness, by him who created male and female, certainly your efforts and deeds are diverse. Now we find that there's a very beautiful link between the two surahs that we've just read. Surah Shams, the surah of the sun, in which Allah tells us of the radiance that does exist within us if we but develop it. Now in Suratul Layl, Allah tells us how we develop this goodness, how we attain that success, how we purify ourselves. Allah starts by telling us that just as night is different from day, just as men are different from women, إِنَّ سَعْيَكُمْ لَشَتَّى. You're all doing different deeds. Some will have more, some will have less, some will have many, and some will have none. فَأَمَّا مَنْ أَعْطَى وَاتَّقَى وَصَدَّقَ بِالْحُسْنَى فَسَنُيَسِّرُهُ لِلْيُسْرَى. As for him who gives and is Allah conscious, it starts with giving. Giving your time for Allah's sake, giving your knowledge for Allah's sake, giving your talents, sharing your energies. مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ. They spend from what we have provided them. A scholar once said, تَصَدَّقْتُ بِإِرْضِي, that I donate my honor, my reputation. In other words, if someone hurts me, if someone insults me, I am actually giving my ego up. I will not feel offended, I will not feel angry, and I am doing that for Allah. فَأَمَّا مَنْ أَعْطَى. It starts with giving. Hasan Basri said, Iman without spending, Iman when you're just claiming Allah knows how much I love him and you're not doing anything for anyone, that's nifaq, that's hypocrisy. مَنْ أَعْطَى وَاتَّقَى. Now why is he giving? Why is he sharing his time, his knowledge, his talents with people? So people admire him? So people say how wonderful he is? No. وَاتَّقَى. He is Allah conscious. He is doing it for Allah's pleasure. وَصَدَّقَ بِالْحُسْنَى. Subhanallah, this confirms goodness. In other words, his conduct is perfect. His dealings with all are perfect. We cannot compartmentalize deen that I say, oh well, I teach the Quran so I can be as cruel and as vicious as I like with my relatives. وَصَدَّقَ بِالْحُسْنَى. He confirms goodness. He disdains not even a small act of goodness. Why does he do it? So people admire him? No, for Allah's sake. As we read yesterday, لَا نُرِيدُ مِنْكُمْ جَزَاءً وَلَا شُكُورًا. We are feeding you for the sake of our Lord. We do not wish for any recompense from you. When we do something from someone, we should not expect them to do anything for us. وَلَا شُكُورًا. Forget they're doing something for us. We should not even want their thanks. Because only such a person is then truly doing it for Allah. So then what lies in store for this person? فَسَنُيَسِّرُهُ لِلْيُسْرَى. We will make smooth for him the path of goodness, the path of ease. The more he turns towards Allah, the more he sacrifices his desires for Allah's sake, Allah will make him draw nearer and nearer to himself, until this person is completely close to Allah. وَأَمَّا مَنْ بَخِلَ وَاسْتَغْنَى. Now we have on the opposite end of the spectrum someone who is stingy. Now how are we stingy? Not just with our wealth. Sometimes we are stingy with our forgiveness. Sometimes we are stingy with our tolerance. Sometimes we are stingy with our time, with our wealth, with our talents. We cannot bear to share. We cannot bear to share our loved ones. We cannot bear to share any of the blessings Allah has given us. Allah says, then let this person know. وَاسْتَغْنَى. Why is he so selfish and stingy? Because he thinks he's self-sufficient. He thinks Allah is going to forgive him. He's not interested in sharing. وَكَذَّبَ بِالْحُسْنَى. Such a person denies goodness. His conduct will be the worst. His behavior, his dealings with all will be the worst. Why? Because of that stinginess, that selfishness within him. فَسَنُيَسِّرُهُ لِلْعُسْرَى. He should beware. Because we will make smooth for him the path of evil. The more he's hurting people, the more vicious he's becoming, he'll go on sinking deeper and deeper into that quicksand of venom and hatred till he himself is destroyed and his tawfiq for goodness will be snatched away. وَمَا يُغْنِي عَنْهُ مَالُهُ إِذَا تَرَدَّى. Does he think his wealth will save him? And what will his wealth help him when he goes down? Truly on us is to give guidance, and truly to us belong the last and the first. This dunya and the hereafter both are for Allah. Therefore I have warned you of a blazing fire. None shall enter it except the most wretched, who denies and turns away. And sometimes we deny by our tongues, and sometimes we deny by our actions. وَسَيُجَنَّبُهَا الْأَتْقَى. And the Allah conscious will be far removed from it. الَّذِي يُؤْتِي مَا لَهُ يَتَزَكَّى. Allah repeats, the Allah conscious, this person who is sharing. He is giving his wealth. Why is he giving his wealth? So his name comes in the newspaper? No. So that he can become purer. So he can purify himself. وَمَا لِيَحَدٍ عِنْدَهُ مِنْ نِعْمَةٍ تُجْزَى. And who has in mind no favor from anyone to be paid back. No ulterior motives. He's not helping people. So people do something for him then. إِلَّا ابْتِغَاءَ وَجْهِ رَبِّهِ الْأَعْلَى. But to seek the countenance of his Lord, the Most High. We find that Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu was constantly buying slaves and freeing them for Allah's sake. Now his father noticed that Hazrat Abu Bakr would buy the weak slaves, the poor slaves, you know, the slaves who were physically weak as well. So his father said to him, why are you buying and freeing these poor slaves, you know? And you should free slaves who are strong, slaves who are healthy, so they can do something for you. He said, I'm not doing it so that they recompense me or repay me. I'm doing it for my Allah. إِلَّا ابْتِغَاءَ وَجْهِ رَبِّهِ الْأَعْلَى. Now every time we do something for someone, let's stop and ask ourselves first. In our heart of hearts, do we want them to acknowledge this deed that we've done? Do we want them to praise us for it? Do we want them to gush over us? Or are we doing it for Allah and Allah alone? Because إِنَّ اللَّهَ طَيِّبٌ لَا يَقْبُلُوا إِلَّا طَيِّبًا. Allah is pure. He only accepts that deed which is exclusively for Him. مَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُو لِقَاءَ رَبِّهِ فَلْيَعْمَلْ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا وَلَا يُشْرِكْ بِعِبَادَةِ رَبِّهِ أَحَدًا. A man asked the Prophet ﷺ, I do a good deed and I want to please Allah, but I want to please people as well. And the Prophet told him, whoever hopes for the meeting of his Lord, فَلْيَعْمَلْ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا. Let him do good deeds. وَلَا يُشْرِكْ بِعِبَادَةِ رَبِّهِ أَحَدًا. Let him not commit any partners in worship with his Lord. No hope for praise, no desire for thanks from people. إِلَّا بَتِغَاءَ وَجْهِ رَبِّهِ الْأَعْلَى. Except to seek the being of his Lord, the most sublime. See, people are never going to repay us anyway. So why should we not do everything we do for Allah? وَلَسَوْفَ يَرْضَى. And he will surely be pleased.
Turn to Allah, he's never far away. Put your trust in Him, raise your hands and pray. Ooh, yeah, Allah, guide my steps, don't let me go astray. You're the only one who can show me the way. Show me.